today's class. So today's class is for class 9. The lesson name is The Snake and the River. So already we have discussed about this lesson in the previous video. Let us revise that and let us continue the next part. So we said we have a homeopath doctor in this lesson, and he was saying his experiences with the snake to his friends. So he had his meal in a restaurant. He came back to his room. As he opened the door, he heard some noises from the above. He thought those noises were made by rats. He went inside, he lighted the lamp, kept it on the table, and he thought to go and sleep. But he couldn't get any sleep, so he went outside of the veranda to get some aid. He didn't get any aid. Then he came back to his room and he thought to read a book. So he opened a book, the Material Medica. He kept it on the table, and on the same table we have one mirror, one comb, and the book which he has thought to read. So before he started to read, he tempted to look into the mirror, and he thought that he should shave daily and grow a thin mustache. Then again, he took a close look into the mirror and thought that he smiled and thought he is looking very attractive when he was smiling. He thought that he should always have that smile on his face so that he looks more handsome. Then again, he got up from the chair, he lit a bidi, and he paced up and down. Paced up and down means he roamed here and there, and he thought that he should marry a girl. Do you remember? He thought that he should marry a fat girl, and along with that, he thought that the girl should be having medical practice and she should have a lot of money. Why he thought that the girl should be very fat? Because if he has done any mistake, the woman shouldn't run over him and catch him. This is what he thought. With all such thoughts, he went back and sat in the same chair. So suddenly he heard a dull thud sound. Means what? Something has fallen from the above. He thought, nothing to worry. I always used to listen to these kind of voices, no? So those are might be rats. I no need to worry, and I can see back, he thought. As he looked back, he saw a snake, and it has on its shoulder. This is the situation which we have explained in the last video. Now what happened next? So when the snake landed on his shoulder, he didn't cry, he didn't jump, he didn't do any of those kind of things, because there is no such time. The snake is on his shoulder. If he has done something, it might bite him. So he didn't do all those things. So what happened? Slowly the snake slithered on his left arm above the elbow. Means here, this part, it has coiled. Coil means what? Twisting and turning. Fully it has coiled on his left arm. So when it has happened like that, he didn't do any kind of things, because if he has done any kind of things, the snake may bite him. Without doing anything, he just sat there like a stone. Stone means what? He is not doing anything, any kind of actions. Just like a stone, he sat there. He could feel the atmosphere of the room. The room was fully dark, and with the light, he can, with that lighted lamp, he sat there in the darkness like a stone, without doing anything. Then suddenly he remembered the God. He thought to ask the help of God. But maybe God didn't listen, it seems, because the snake didn't go. It was there only. He thought to write a bright letters so that God can see his pain. Later, he thought, what if the snake strikes me, what medicine should I take? There is no medicine in my room. After all, I am a stupid and poor doctor, he thought. Then he smiled. Slowly, with this such thought, he smiled. But what happened? These thinkings and all he was doing, and the snake has coiled his left arm, right? It was like a molten knot. Molten means what? weapon is forehead, he thought. And again he thought, is it a male or a female? I don't know, right, he thought. Because he was thinking that the snake might grow a mustache. And he is also seeing that it may use mascara. So he doesn't know what kind of snake it is. Whether it is male or female, he don't know. Then slowly what happened? The snake has leapt onto his lap and landed on the table. Because it wanted to see its reflection in a close quarter. So from him, it left and landed on the table to observe its face closely. Then what the homeopath doctor has done? It was admiring its beauty in the mirror, no? It went on to the table. So without any late, he got up from the chair, went outside of Varanda, and he ran and ran until he reaches his friend's home. He went there, he has applied oil full over his body, and he took a bath. So when the friends who were listening, the doctor is narrating this story to the friends, right? They all felt very relaxed when the doctor said he left the home and went to his friend's home. They all lit their beads, and one of the friends, one of the listener who is listening to the homeopath doctor's story, he asked, "Doctor, is your wife very fat?" Because before he said that he wanted to marry a fat woman. So the friends, one of the fellow who were listening to his story asked, "Is your wife very fat?" Then doctor said, "No, I will something and God will otherwise. My wife is a really and she is also a sprinter," he said. Really person means not pleasant. Really means not pleasant. And he also said that she is a sprinter, means fast runner. Sprinter means fast runner. Actually, what he thought, she should be very fat so that he cannot run and catch him. But what kind of wife he got? She is a fast runner. So what he thought to marry, he couldn't get those kind of a wife. She got a wife who can run very fast. Then one of the other fellows has asked, "Doctor, when you ran out from the room, did the snake follow?" They asked. Then doctor said, I never see such a snake which is admiring its own self. So I ran and the snake didn't follow me," he said. Then again, they said, "Did you go to that home again?" Then doctor says, "The next day, I went to my room to bring my things. Along with the two four friends of him, he went to his room to change the room from that. And to change the room, he has to bring all his things, right? So he went to his room to bring all the things. But when they went and saw, there was nothing. Fully, there is no things in his room. One of the thief has come and stolen all the things. But the doctor said, the thief has left one thing as an insult. What is that one thing? Vest. At first we said, no, vest means an undergarment which we wear. So the thief has left this vest in his room and went. It is an insult only, right? Because when at first the doctor was explaining, he said the vest is not so wide. Means what? It is very